बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर्स। लेट्स डिस्कस लो कास्ट नो कास्ट टीचिंग मटेरियल। देयर इज अ पैराडाइम शिफ्ट इन क्लासरूम पेडागोजीज यूज्ड बाय टीचर्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। न्यू टीचिंग मेथोडोलॉजीज हैव रिप्लेस्ड द कन्वेंशनल टीचिंग लर्निंग मेथोडोलॉजीज। चाक एंड टाक, दाउ नॉट फुली रिडंडेंट, हैज बिकम समवट ऑब्सोलीट। ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड टीचर्स आर इनोवेटिंग न्यू टीचिंग एड्स टू मेक टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस मोर इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इफेक्टिव। Making and using teaching and learning materials is an important part of teaching. There are few manufactured teaching material for purchase which are very expensive, and thus the third world countries cannot afford that. Import of teaching material from other countries at a given level are a heavy financial burden for especially developing countries. Low-cost teaching material is that which produced by the factories of local areas of the country. Its spare parts are also easily approachable, and its cost is always lower than imported equipments from other countries. Low-cost teaching aids involve minimal or nil input costs, as they are made from household waste and discarded items or from materials readily available in our immediate environment. Low-cost teaching aids can be used in nursery, primary, middle, secondary and senior secondary schools. It can be used at all levels if the teachers and the users, they are skillful in using low-cost, no-cost material. Of course, the type as well as the number of aids to be used in a given subject would vary from one class to another. But broadly speaking, primary and middle school students can be engaged in making simple items with rudimentary materials such as sheets of papers, cardboard, and thermocol using scissors, glue, etc. Whereas senior school students could develop teaching aids using metal, wood, plastic, rubber, etc. Advantages of low-cost, no-cost teaching material. The major concerns of developing countries are food supply, livelihood, health, nutrition, and growth and economy. At the level of the student and his family, food, health, and livelihood are primary concern. The use of low-cost, no-cost teaching material for science education has certain important advantages in developing countries. The first advantage is cheapness. Investment in the equipment for all students at given level are a heavy financial burden for a developing country. Thus, we can say that low-cost and no-cost material are very cheap and save funds in this regard. No fear or loss. There is another risk in connection with the high cost of equipment. It is sometimes safely locked up in the schools and not used at all because the teacher is afraid that he, she or the students might break it and that he, she will have pay for it from his or her own pocket. In the use of low cost, no cost teaching material, there is no fear of loss or any other risk of damage. Proper use. The costs of locally produced equipments are often low, but not always, lower than the imported equipment. When calculating the cost of equipment, some factors should be kept in mind. They are durability of equipment, additional installation costs, service costs, cost of teacher and technician training. We should also keep in mind that most expensive equipment is that which is never used. Thus, low cost, no cost material can easily be used instead of imported equipment. The other advantage is same principle. Low cost, no cost teaching equipment illustrate the same principles as imported expensive equipment. Another one is maintenance and repair. If equipment is simpler in design, teacher, laboratory technicians and local craftsmen are more likely to be able to carry out small repair. This is another advantage. High school content, equipment made of parts and material familiar to the students is more likely to help the students. Self-reliance, it cultivates confidence and expertise to educators in developing countries. Related to real life, teachers need to realize the significance of practical work in science education as well as the use of social resources in laboratory activities. It is, in simple words, related to life, the low-cost, no-cost material, because it is designed by the students and teachers. Economic. It is very difficult to establish science laboratories and demonstration rooms due to financial constraints. Many science equipments for several experiments can be produced under their low-cost variety. Helpful for teacher. Because of the overcrowded classroom, teachers cannot provide individual attention to students. Thus, using low-cost, no-cost material, the teacher can easily pay attention to the students. active method, group work, and fun. Making and using low-cost equipment encourage the active method and group work can be great fun. Each people can make his or her own equipment and even bring it home. It is the active method of learning. The strength of low-cost, no-cost material. Made of paper, wood, metal, strings, etc., such equipment can be treated roughly with no damage. Hence, people feel more at ease. Low-cost teaching aids can be used for supplementary and illustrative education in the sciences as well as the humanities. However, they are most suitable for subjects like science, geography, mathematics, and arts and crafts. Low-cost teaching aids made from household waste and trash serve a particularly useful purpose. With a bit of creativity and imagination, scraps of metal, wood, plastic, rubber, paper, etc. can metamorphose into valuable items which can be used as effective teaching tools. System-wide use of low-cost teaching aids will not only boost teacher-student creativity and involvement, help institutional budget go a longer way, but also serve to keep our immediate environment clean. These are some benefits of low-cost, no-cost teaching material, but there is a need for training. The teacher must be trained in this regard. Thus, it can be very beneficial to use low-cost, no-cost material instead of imported material. This was about low-cost, no-cost teaching material. Thank you for watching.